Oh, great time for my ears to pop. Fucking. What's up? People. What you doing? This thing. Do y'all know what this is? Do y'all know what time it is? It is. You would think it was an Epiphone, right? But it's not. It's chiffon. It, you would think it's chiffon the way the freaking paint job is, right? Pretty freaking wild. Well, the neck is certainly, you know, certainly an Epiphone. That's without a doubt. But this body, the neck that was busted, that came from here. I had to put a ton of freaking putty, wood fill, underneath here to make up for the space. And I was going to, I don't know, I this is the one, this is weighs a ton. It's got to be at least like freaking 13 pounds. But that might be the, you know, that might be the good thing about it. I don't know. It could be. Tried something very interesting. This pickup came from, it's got a nice Christmas color. I gotta say that. This pickup came from, I believe, a Yamaha. And it's hot. The both of these pickups were both freaking 16K, right? So, and I knew that they weren't, like, all that great. Okay, I just put them in here because I wanted to get this. She was staring at me and saying, "You're neglecting me." So I took an extra magnet and I put it on the back of it to make it hotter. Because they weren't that hot. They weren't that hot at all. And, in fact, they were mediocre. They're still mediocre, but I can't even tell you whether it sounds great or not. I mean, except for, you know, when in the off. It rings for days. For days. It rings for days. So I knew the neck was good. Didn't have to worry about the neck. Put it on here. The tone just went, yes, baby. One thing I got to do is I got to get better freaking tuners. Because these are those bullshit fake Clausen tuners. And they're not even the Epiphone tuners. I can't remember where I exactly got these from. But they're not even the Epiphone tuners. So, but I did know that when I put the neck on here, it was just too happy. It was too happy. So I and the other neck that I was working on, that I was gonna pull the truss rod out and replace it, the truss rod was working. No problem. The only problem was is that it had the back bow from hell. So right now it's being clamped down and being adjusted. And that one, I'm pretty sure I'm going to wind up putting that neck, if she winds up being okay, into this body. Now this body is not a plywood body. and I'm not too sure what the hell I was thinking about when I started carving it up. But I started carving it up, and I made it. It's just really comfortable, like super comfortable. Because I don't know if you can tell, but she's like cut to the max. And I'm just thinking that I'm gonna probably fill this up and go a little freaking Steve Morse and create a little freaking block here. Recess the tunematic and drop that in, and then put the freaking, you know, put that neck on there and play with that and see if that freaking works. I don't know. All I know is that neck is like really, really narrow. Really narrow. So and this one's got great tone. I just gotta find the right, like, so the pick, this pickup, when I put the extra freaking magnet on there, I wanted to increase the output because it's a 16, like I said, they're 16k ohm freaking pickups. But this one, for some reason, is for crap. And this one is loud. It's just loud. Sounds similar, but that's because I got this guy. Right. I got the puppy dialed back some. So and the thing is that I bend the strings on this puppy and and she don't hold the tune. I mean, she don't like. That's that. The other thing is the flipping intonation. Hopefully, if I flip these saddles around, I'll be able to recover some of the space that I need to travel back to get the, because she's coming up sharp. And if she's coming up sharp, then I got to move it back. Because that was the one thing that I realized with this. I moved it back. I moved this side back, but I moved it back just a little too far. But it's not too bad because where the saddles are, it sits fine. But this guy's got to come back a touch. I'm hoping that I don't have to drill out again and move it back. I can just freaking flip the saddles and do that. But the truss rail works okay on this guy, and I just missed this one because this one's a pretty sentimental bitch. I've got the saddle slammed to the ground, and The action is a little high, but not, you know, it's not death-defyingly high. So, I don't know. Somehow I lost the thing. The thing is that here's the thing with Red. I call it Red. Red has given up. Red was a problem child. And Red wound up giving up freaking, you know, giving up parts of herself so that others may live. So, you know, like, this is not the original. That's not the original. None of this is the original. This is not the original. I think the Switch is. I'm not quite sure. I think the Switch is original. Definitely the pickups are not original. The strings. The neck, obviously, right? The pots aren't freaking original. Those two are original. They're skinny shit, the little tiny shits. But the big guys, I just put those in today and dropped these freaking Mama Jammas in there. I might play with another cap and see if that works. But other than that, you know, paint job was all freaking torn to hell. Had to get better screws, because the screws that were in there were freaking crazy. Did a sick-ass mod job over here just to get the, like I said, when I filled this damn thing up, to get the neck to come to the right. Otherwise, it was almost below the freaking, like the frets were right on the... The frets were right on the body. I was like, yeah, that's not fucking right. That ain't gonna work. Where are you? So, that being said, there was a little bit of a battle going on here. Because it wanted to back bow all of a sudden, and then I was like, I don't think so, bitch. And I didn't know what to do. So I messed with it a little bit, and I futzed around and tried to get the tension on there and played with the freaking the truss rod, and all of a sudden it said, yeah, okay, we'll do that. So I was like, all right, so it's straight with a little bit, with a touch of freaking relief, and no more back bow to that. This where it's not doing that no more, because this was buzzing the frick out, and I'm like, what happened? And that's what was happening with that. So, it plays. Plays great, man. If there is one thing, and I mentioned this before, if there was one thing I was gonna do with it, it's definitely, definitely freaking the pickups now, you know. And I was gonna do something with the top, but I really, the red in the binding, I mean, you can't really tell too well. But it's got some kind of freaking orangey red freaking thing going on there, and it's just pretty. It's just pretty. I was unsure whether to go with the cream I mean, the, you know, the aesthetics and shit. Go with the cream or go with the black. And I'm like, oh, I'm all confused now. So I was like, oh, what the hell. So, how are you doing? I will say this. Does, right? Fucking, she plays fucking great, man. I mean, this is what I was saying the other day. I'm bouncing around here a bit. That they all sound good. They all sound good in one form or another. They all sound good. That's why when Heather asked me, you know, she was like, you know, so which one did you do you think, you know, could, you know, that you're unhappy with? I'm like, they all fucking sound great, man. I'm like, I don't know. The other thing is, I figured this out. Oh, yeah. So, I was saying that I had gotten this puppy back wired up to the speakers. So now, all 8 freaking speakers are wired up. This side has, this guy's got 2 on here, 2 over there. And the Fender's got 2 over there and 2 over here. So, it's all freaking going on at the same time. And I was going to make an ABY switch. So that I can get the 2 things going on. The big complaint that I've been finding out doing the research is that with the ABY switches is that there's a ground loop problem and you get this hum. And I figured out how to work out some kind of freaking rectifier kind of thingamabob that eliminates that. Or you can use a high pass filter or a tank filter or something like that. And you can, undo that as well. So, I wasn't worried about that too much. I have the top for this, but I was going to use this as the ABY switch and start playing around with that. I'm still working on the thought of it, but I have it hooked up where it goes right to the freaking, the digital delay, and the digital delay is stereo, so it's got 2 outputs, no ground loop problems. I'm like, yeah, we're going to go with that. That eliminates all my freaking problems. I don't have to worry about that. No problem. And it still splits when it's off. I mean, like, that's super dynamic. So, the only thing that I was contending with using this again, was debating on whether I should use the modeling. And I've come to the conclusion that I'm just going to use the clean channel, and if I want to use some, you know, delay or flange or chorus or whatever, I'll do that. But I'm not going to use any of the models, the amp models. I'm going to keep it on clean. And I found out that I have to work with the gain a bit and turn that up a touch. But that's about it. And it's not bad. And it does. Pretty much competes with the freaking Fender, and so I won't, at that level, not a big problem. In fact, I can't bump up the lows. From here, you know, and that would be fine. I don't have a problem with that. It does the overdrive, no problem. It does don't like a hyper metal pedal too much, but I'm not, you know, I'm not worried about that. See, Fender don't have a problem. Remember I was telling you I was gonna get the woofers for the freaking Fender for the... Now, if I try to remember what the f- it's a deluxe, Hot Rod Deluxe, because it's a 410, right? And I was gonna get the speakers because they were cheap. It was like $30 for two, right? And that's with shipping. Oh, they changed the prices, so now it's $20 a pop. Which I guess is still freaking pretty good. They're 200 watts a piece. So I can't, I'm not. I should really shut up about that because it is what it is. It's just that, you know, after. It's December, it's Christmas, you know, it's like, frick, ah. I was like, after the iPad for the little one, and I was like, that was huge, and I still got two more freaking things to get, and I'm like, you know, holy crap, and my other one, she's out there somewhere, so I got to figure out what the hell she needs, so I got to start working on that, you know, just to help her out while she's, you know, getting her feet back on the ground. She finally started working at this place, and she's new in this area, so. Gotta do the right thing for your kids, man. Staying in tune now because I'm not freaking bending like crazy. So I don't know. I mean, it's funny. I mean, if you look at the strings, you could see where they got a little dented from the freaking going back and forth and whatever. I was gonna mothball this bitch, but I'm like, why? I was like, and then the only other thing was, you know, because I had thinking about there are patterns. If you go to Weight Relief in Google, if you go to Weight Relief, you'll see the patterns that they use. So I was going to print out the pattern and start freaking, you know, cutting it out. Well, that's that, you know, I was going to cut all of that, you know, cut out chunks of it so I can get, you know, yeah, this is a plywood guitar. You know how you can tell? I didn't think it was a plywood guitar, but do you know how you can tell it's a plywood guitar? Look at the layers. Hopefully you were able to see the layers. I don't know, because it weighs a ton, so I really can't. We all know about that one. Uh, I was going to go on and on and on and on and on about a certain something, but... The crowd I hang out with just doesn't freaking... They're not that... They're into their own thing. So I'll leave them alone. I'll be nice. See how low that is? And that's with an extra magnet. That's really kind of insane low, right? By comparison, tell me that's freaking crazy low. That's like crazy low. That's like, Dan, maybe you should think about throwing another fucking pickup in there low. But, you know, I don't know, because... It's not that bad. Because the low pickup does have its freaking applications. But, all things considered, it's probably better off. It's probably better off. Hit the road, buddy. I don't know what to do. Yeah, I do. I'll just freaking rip the bitch out. I've raised it up, you know, and it didn't improve it that much. I don't want to raise it up too much because, you know, that totally affects the tone, right? I mean, at least the sustain is it'll wind up starting to pull on the freaking whatchamacallit somewhat. So, anyway, with that being said, we'll figure out what else is going on for the week. And like that, and whatnot. I don't know why it does. Oh, that's because they're both the same freaking pots, right? So, I guess I'll let you guys go. This was the Baxxon, and it's now, you can't even say it's an Epiphone, right? You can't say it's an Epiphone. Although, you know, the neck is an Epiphone, so you could call it a standard. What would you call it? A standard? A traditional? If you wanted to call it a freaking Epiphone, can't call it an Epiphone. Standard, traditional, I don't know what the fuck you want to call it. Yes, I do have the plate. See? Got the plate. Took some freaking hits back there, I'll tell you that. It's a war horse. But, or I just might get another set of freaking GFS fat pats and throw them in there and freaking say, yeah, buddy. This is the way you play. And just, you know, and just say, you know, this is it. This is, you know, frick the weight relief. Just do it the way it needs to be done. And hook up the tuners and get good tuners in there. Probably get a set of Go-To's or Gatto's or Grover's, right? Or GFS has a decent, you know, a Guitar Fetish. They got decent ones also. I don't know if I'm going to go with Locking, because they're almost the same price, $30. Right? So, $60, I think it was. Yeah, I think it was like $60 for the fucking tuners. Anyway, you got some suggestions or whatever, you know, let me know. I had a bitch of a time, man. Freaking, this just didn't, it didn't want to center. And then the way this pickup was, it didn't want to center to that freaking either. I mean, here was fine. But then I had to throw a clamp on it and freaking bend that bitch and freaking get these things straightened out. Once those straightened out, this started centering. And I was like, but it's still off. It's still off. You know what I mean? It's not completely aligned. And if it's not completely aligned with that, I can imagine how it was with the freaking, I don't even remember how it was with the original freaking neck. But I'm loving the incarnation that it has become. And, you know, you always wind up with one of those freaking secret weapons. What the hell is that? You never mind. You know? What are you playing on that? Never mind. Slim is just chilling out. Lucille's chilling out. Yeah, I gots to go. Peace, love, and happiness, and all that good shit. And I'll catch you guys on the flip. And, I'm still not hearing anything. You guys not working on any freaking projects? Jesse's freaking giving away guitars like a madman. And I'm like, damn. I wish I had a fucking knock-knock joke. Later. Have a good one. Peace. Love y'all. I got enough guitars, Jess. I don't need another fucking guitar. I think I'm done. I'll tell you what. I think I'm done. I think I'm not going to freaking grab another one. Maybe for a year. I'll take a year off. And I'll spend the rest of this year just working on chord construction and theory and freaking scales and modes and stuff like that. Found a decent... found some decent courses that I can actually, my head can actually get with, and I don't feel stupid, you know. I mean, I still feel lost, like I, and then there is another video by Frank Gambale, and he does one on modes. I watched like half of it. I was like, wow. I was like, okay, this is starting to make sense. And then the Rock On Good People, freaking people over there, that were Next Level Guitar, the owner, I think it is, He does some courses, like from the very beginning, like 8 years ago. Go back and look at the very beginning. A lot of good stuff on there. I was like, oh, thank you. Because I feel so retarded. And I've been playing without freaking knowing any theory and shit like that. So I'm like, I think it's time. If I'm going to move in the forward direction, I need to freaking start buckling down and just freaking start getting this shit together. Because... I'm like at a plateau, you know, as far as it comes to freaking just learning licks and shit like that. I'm like, I can only go so far because I can only go so far. So, you know, maybe I just need to freaking start working on other shit so I can just slowly, continuously get better holistically all around. Right? Once again, I'll talk to you guys later. Have a good one. And let me know, you know, if you find anything that worked for you as far as like learning and shit like that, that helped you, you know, propelled you a bit. All right? Peace, people.